Hello student, I am P.Kumar of EEE Education Center. Within this session, we'll discuss the resistance of a conductor depends on which factors. We'll discuss within this session. The resistance of a wire is R. R is the resistance of a wire. The resistance depends upon the three factors. When the temperature is constant, then the resistance depends upon the length of the conductor and the area of the cross sections, and it also depends upon the nature of the conductors. So we can say that the resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. R is the resistance, this is the length, and the resistance also depends upon the inversely proportional to the area of the cross sections. If the more area of the conductor, then the resistance will less. R is inversely proportional to the area of cross section. It means if the area is more, then the resistance will less. And combining this, this is the first equation and this is the second equation. Combining these two equations, R is equal to, R is directly proportional to length by A. If the proportionality constant is removed, then we have to give a constant. So the R is equal to resistivity L upon A, where this is known as the proportionality constant. Rho is the proportionality constant. So this is known as the resistivity of conductor. It means the resistance of the wire at a constant temperature, since the resistivity of the wire depends upon the temperature. If the temperature is constant, the resistance of a conductor depends upon its length, area of the cross sections, and nature of the conductors. If the length of the conductor is increased, definitely the resistance will also increase. If the area of the cross sections is increased, the resistance of the conductor will decrease. Now we are trying to solve the numerical related to this topic. The question number 1, the resistance of a wire of a length L is 20 ohm. If the length of the wire is doubled, what will be the new resistance of this conductor? Here R is 20 ohm. Length of the conductor is L and the resistivity of the conductor is rho. So the R is equal to rho L by A, where A is the area of cross section. The next part of this question, if the length of the conductor is doubled, it means the new length of the conductor is 2L. What will be the new area of cross sections? Let A dash is the new area of the cross section. Since the mass of the length will not change, what the length of the L is the length of the conductor, A is the area of the conductor. If the length is double, it means that is equal to L dash is equal to L dash is the new length of the conductor, and this is equal to the length is double, it means the new length will be equal to 2L. A dash is the new area of the cross sections. Since we know that the mass of the length is not changed, mass of conductor is constant, so volume of conductor is constant. So A into L, that is equal to L into L dash. This is the A into L, this is the volume of the old conductor, and A dash and L dash is the volume of the new conductor. Since the volume is not changed, so both are equal. Now we see that the A dash into length of the conductor is double, so that is equal to 2L. So the A dash is equal to A by 2. It means if the length is doubled, the area of cross sections will half of the original area of the cross sections. Here we have to calculate it. A dash is the new area of the cross section, that is equal to A by 2. Now it is easy to calculate the new resistance of the conductor. late R dash is the new resistance. And this is equal to, since the resistivity at a constant temperature is not changed, hence rho L dash upon A dash, so the R dash is equal to resistivity, L dash is equal to 2L, and the area of the cross section is equal to A by 2. So this is equal to 4. 4 is taken here, so the 4L rho L by A, that is equal to R dash, and this is equal to 4. This is rho L upon A is the old resistance, and this is equal to 20 ohm. So the R dash is equal to 4 into 20, that is equal to 80 ohm, since the R is equal to 20 ohm given. So thus we easily calculate the new resistance of the conductor is equal to 80 ohm. The next question, second question, is 60 ohm resistance wire is doubled on it. Calculate the new resistance. According to the questions, the resistance of the wire is 16 ohm. If this is the according to the questions, the resistance of this wire is equal to R is the resistance, and this is equal to 16 ohm, and length of this conductor is L. This length is fold and it is cut. Now this wire is doubled in this way. This is the wire and it is cut in this way. Now if it is the L is the length of this, it is doubled. It means the length of this conductor will be half. The new resistance L dash is equal to L by 2. Since again the volume of the conductor will not change, so this is equal to the volume of the old conductor is equal to A L is equal to A dash L dash, and the new length of this conductor is equal to L by 2. A L is equal to A dash L by 2. So the A dash is equal to A and A will the cancel out. L and L will the cancel out. So according to the question, AL is equal to A dash and length of this conductor is equal to L by 2. So L and L will cancel out. So the A dash, new area of the cross section is equal to 2 times A will come along the direction. So that is equal to 2 times of the area of the cross sections. So the new resistance of the conductor is equal to R dash is the new resistance. So this is equal to R dash is equal to resistivity L dash A dash, and we know the new length is equal to half of the original length, and the new area of the cross section is the double of the original area of the cross section. So this is equal to resistivity, and this is equal to L by 2 divided by area of the cross sections of this is equal to 2A rho L by 4A. So this is equal to taken out 1 by 4 rho L upon A, and this is equal to original resistance. Rho L by A is the original resistance, and this is equal to what? This is equal to 16 ohm. So this is equal to 1 by 4. So this is equal to 4 ohm. Understand? So the new resistance is equal to 1 by 4 into 16 ohm. Thank you.